Hello, welcome to Public Spot. I'm George. Today, I'll be doing something different. I will show you how I write a Lambda function using TDD approach, or test-driven development. Let's start coding. So what I will try to achieve today is to write an AWS Lambda function that will generate new access keys for a user. I have installed Python, pip, and virtualenv on my machine to do my development work. And the two primary Python modules that I'll be using include moto, which allows AWS calls in the background, and moto, which is essentially a way for me to mock calls to AWS. So I'll start by creating a space for my code. And then inside the Lambda directory, I will set up my Python virtual environment and then call it dev. I'll activate my virtual environment. Now inside the Lambda directory, I will create two requirements.txt file, one for the main modules and then another one for my modules that I need for testing. And then in my requirements.txt, I'll add moto 3. And then on my requirements test.txt, I'll add moto, pytest, and pyyaml. I'll go ahead and install my modules inside my virtual environment. Now that all my Python modules are installed, I'll start creating a directory inside Lambda called app. And then inside my app directory, I'll start creating my test file. I will start with the simplest test case. So this assertion actually failed because we have a space in there. So let's fix that, save that, and then run our test again. Now we've got a first successful test. Let's go ahead and move on to the next test case. So what if I allow the parameter access and secret values to be provided by the caller? So I would create a new test case for this. Save my changes and run my test again. And then we have failed tests. Let's just have a look. It says it takes 3 positional arguments, but 5 were given. So let's fix that. Save changes and then run our test again. So again, all my test cases are successful. So now I need to set a test case that will test the actual creation of the access key. Save our changes on our test.py and then run our test again. So mock IAM is not defined, so let's fix that. Save our changes, run our test again. We have another error, moto 3 is not defined, let's fix that. So as expected, my test case failed. It's looking for the implementation of that new method. And if we look at our test case, it's actually expecting values to be populated in my SSM. So what I need to do is implement the part where it populates my parameter store inside SSM. Now that we've fixed the implementation, let's save our changes and then run our test again. So far, all my test cases have passed. So now I need to make sure that my parameter values are not empty. Let me implement a test case for it. save my changes and run my tests again. As expected, our test case failed because our assertions are not satisfied. So let's go ahead and fix that test case. Save our changes, then run our test again. So now I need to create a new test case for a user that doesn't exist. Before I start implementing the test case for handling users that doesn't exist, I need to import the module that I need to handle the exceptions, and that module is moto core. So I need to go all the way to the top of my test.py. Save that, and then I can start creating my test case. Save my changes and run my test again. My test case ran successfully, which means we do not have to implement anything to handle the exception. What I've written so far is capable of handling situations where user that does not exist, so we are good. Now on to the next test case. AWS imposes limit of 2 access keys per IAM, so I will create a test case for this. Save my changes and run our test. As expected, the test case failed and the assertions are not satisfied. The way to fix this is that I have to implement a way of deleting old access keys before creating a new one. Save our changes, open terminal, clear this, and then run our test again. My test case failed because of an incorrect assertion that I used at line 89. Instead of assert equal, this should be assert true. Save that, and then run my test again. And now all my 6 test cases are successful. And my final set of test cases are for the handler method of my Lambda function. So let me write that up. Save my test.py and then run my test again. As expected, the test case failed, so let's go ahead and fix it. All 7 test cases that I have set up are run successfully, and so the last bit that I want to set up as a test case is exceptions when calling handler. So let me add that test case. Run our test. So all 8 test cases that I've written have ran and completed successfully. So at this point, I have completed writing my Lambda function code that will generate new access keys for users. And if you've been working with AWS, you'd know that one of the items in AWS well-architected framework is ensuring that all access keys for IAM users are rotated regularly. So this Lambda function will come in very handy. Anyways, let's edit in there. And on the next episode, I will show you how I create a Docker image and set up this Lambda function infrastructure that would use this Docker image. So that's it for now. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Send me some likes or share this video if you find it useful, and subscribe to this channel. Until next time, see ya.